Can I tell you about a new number? So it's a very scary number. It's a bit evil. It's Belphegor's prime. Okay, so Belphegor, one of the seven princes of hell. And the reason there's seven princes is because there are, of course, seven deadly sins. He's also hell's ambassador to France. I didn't know hell had ambassadors to different countries. Makes you wonder who hell's ambassador to England is, right? But Nigel Farage or something. Anyway, so what is Belphegor's prime? Okay, so let's he has a number.
One.
So this number here is Belphegor's prime. So you can already see the evil lurking within there, right? Number of the beast, 666, sitting square in the middle. But it's even more evil than this. 13 zeros on either side of the 666. Of course, 13 being the classic unlucky number. And the other thing that's evil about this is that there's actually 31 digits. And of course, 31 is 13 backwards, isn't it? So this is a fundamentally evil number. It's one of a larger class of numbers, which are called the Belphegor numbers. So a Belphegor number is basically anything, so B of N, so the nth Belphegor number, is a 1 with N zeros, 666, and then another N zeros, and then a 1. Okay, so any Belphegor number has this form. If you want to be fancy about it and write a nice formula for it, the formula you would write is, this is 10 to the n plus 3 plus 666 times 10 to the n plus 1 plus 1. These are the Belphegor numbers. Now, the vast majority of them are not prime, okay? So which ones are prime? Well, of course, for n equals 13, it's a prime number because that's our classic Belphegor prime. N equals 0 is also a prime number. So that's, of course, this guy. Right, and this is also a very, this is another example of a Belphegor prime. This is the classic one, but this is another one. And this is quite interesting as well for other reasons. So this is the 1928th prime number, okay? So this is its prime index. And if you take the numbers from here and add them together, so 1 plus 6 plus 6 plus 6 plus 1, well, that's 20. And you take these numbers and you add them together, like 1 plus 9 plus 2 plus 8. Well, that's also 20, so that's weird. Okay.
That's tenuous.
That is, do you reckon? Okay, well, let's not stop. We're going to get more tenuous, Brady. Don't worry about that. So this is also, this one here as well, this particular Belphegor prime, is also a Republican prime. A Republican prime is any number which is essentially prime to the right. Okay, so it could be a Republican prime in England, supposed to be a Tory prime. Okay, so it's prime to the right. So you take the right-hand side of the number, not counting the middle. So in this case here, 61, and that's a prime number. So it's kind of a coincidence that, well, I don't know what it says about Donald Trump, but this Belphegor prime is also a Republican prime, but we'll leave you to speculate on that.
Do you get Democratic primes or
you
like
do get Democratic
primes?
Yes, you do. You do. That's of course if you take it to the left. Yes, of course this is not. This is clearly not a Democratic prime because 16 is not a prime number. Okay, this set of numbers, these Belphegor numbers, and the Belphegor primes were discovered by the famous prime number hunter Harvey Dubner, who is basically, he's an amateur number theorist. He built a massive computer in his garage with his son, and he just hunts for prime numbers. And this was one of the ansatzes that he shoved into his computer to see if he could find examples of prime numbers. He came up with this one. There are a few others, there are more, obviously. N equals 42 is one, which is pretty interesting, because that's, of course, the meaning of life, right? N equals 506 is the next one. And there's a whole tower of these, okay? Are there an infinite number? Well, we don't know. And the reason we definitely don't know is because this is an example of a palindromic prime. So it obviously looks the same forward and backwards. And we don't know if there are an infinite number of palindromic primes. So we certainly don't know there's an infinite number of Belphegor primes. It's also a naughty prime. Obviously, not just because it's Belphegor. It's a naughty prime. A naughty prime is one that has more noughts or zeros than any other number. And of course, this example does. So it's also a naughty prime.
I've never heard of that. That's brilliant.
Naughty primes. Yeah, they're pretty cool, aren't they? What else is it? It's lots of things. It's a beastly prime. Okay, so a beastly prime is one that has 666 in it. Now, this one has it in a very special place right in the middle, right? But a beastly prime is one that has 666. So, for example, another beastly prime is this one. 6661. 26669 is a beastly prime. There's a whole bunch of these as well. There's loads of these beastly prime, anything with 666 in it.
We're not finished yet. If you want to know even more about this evilness, check out the extra video on Numberphile 2.
This is, I think, quite scary as well. And this one hasn't got a name as far as I know.
And there'll be a bit of a twist.
I didn't want this to be all about evil, right? So I thought we should try to redress the balance with a bit of good.
But if you'd like to know more about 666 itself, of course, we've done a video about that in the past. Check out links on the screen and down in the video description.